We often hear the word nostalgia when discussing films and shows these days, generally in a negative way. It's almost become a cliché to talk about how the film industry panders to our rose-tinted glasses, most obviously in the case of the Disney remakes, films that are explicitly made to bring in fans of the original versions. It's gotten to the point where the same actor comes back to replay the character that he originated 25 years prior.
Everything the light touches is our kingdom. Everything the light touches is our kingdom.
It makes financial sense to cash in on nostalgia. It's an almost guaranteed way to attract an audience to your content if it has elements of what they already enjoy. All of us like to complain about how Disney is out of ideas, but I can give you 1.6 billion reasons why 2019's Lion King is a masterpiece. To the point where the quote-unquote live-action version is now the highest-grossing animated film of all time. This has created a debate on the effect these nostalgia-driven films have on the film industry as a whole. Regardless of whether or not you're for or against these films that prey on nostalgia, it's undeniable that they make a lot of money and attract a lot of attention. Attention which inevitably is taken away from newer films with original concepts. And that's not to say that all films and shows that contain nostalgic elements are inherently bad or harmful to the industry. In fact, that's what this video is about. I think it only makes sense to talk about a particular type of film that, in my opinion, uses nostalgia correctly and in service of film as a medium. These are films that use nostalgia in a rather more subtle way than the hammered-in method used by companies such as Disney or Warner Bros. Rather than banking on the recognition of classic and beloved characters, these films use the conventions of classic and beloved genres. There are many films that do this, but I'm going to pick two specific examples to highlight my point. Damien Chazelle's La La Land, and Rian Johnson's Knives Out. I've picked these two because I think they are very different films that both do one very specific thing: revitalize an old genre in a way that honors its past while pushing it forward to new territory. Neither of these films are based on a particular pre-existing source material, and yet they've both been praised for their nostalgic feel. So let's take a look at how that works. Spoilers for both of them from here on out. La La Land is a movie musical. Now, one would say that's not a genre that needs a revival, considering the movie musical has been pretty active throughout most of film history. Like most genres, it's had its ups and downs, but we've generally seen a steady trend of musicals come to theaters every so often. From great adaptations of Broadway musicals, to Mamma Mia, to Rocketman, to Mamma Mia, Here We Go Again.
Shut up! Shut up! Shut up!
However, La La Land is a send-up to the golden age of movie musicals. By the way, every film genre has had a golden age at some point. The golden age of movie musicals took place between the 1940s and 60s. La La Land particularly pays homages to Jacques Demy's 1967 films The Young Girls of Rochefort, in terms of how it's focused on jazz and dance, and 1951's An American in Paris for its visuals. The film pays a lot of homages to the musicals that came before it, both in Easter eggs but also in its cinematography. These classic musicals put a lot of emphasis on choreography and spectacle, with many of the shots drawn out to appreciate the fact that there's little editing trickery when it comes to the dancing. La La Land echoes this with a focus on the choreography and dancing in long, sweeping takes. In terms of its colors, they're also vibrant and saturated, much like the colorful films that inspired it. The color symbolism in La La Land is simple but very clever and effective. I've linked a video to it here. On the other hand, Knives Out is a whodunit a la Agatha Christie. It pays homage to detective films from the 70s and 80s, particularly those starring the famous Hercule Poirot.
Poirot.
Rian Johnson published a list of the films that inspired him when making Knives Out, and three of the nine he mentioned were based on Agatha Christie stories. Johnson has repeatedly stated that he wanted to create a film like the classic whodunits he used to watch with his family, with an ensemble cast and a quirky detective. A good old-fashioned mystery, as it were. This is echoed not only in the concept and writing, but in the style as well. The film itself was carefully crafted to echo the look and feel of those classic films. For example, while it was shot on digital, director of photography Steve Yedlin worked hard to emulate the look of classic film, which he breaks down in an interview I've linked below. So as you can see, both La La Land and Knives Out use the style and genre of the classics they're inspired by. But I think there's more than that. I mentioned before that these films have no particular source material. There is no Broadway version of La La Land that ran for years, and Agatha Christie didn't pen Benoit Blanc's cases. These are films that are inspired by the stylistic conventions of the genres that the directors love. Big whoa, what's the big deal then? Well, here's where I think it gets interesting. Sure, the films succeed in emulating the style of the films they're inspired by. But the important aspect is not where they adhere to the genre, but in where they break away from it. If they were only following the look and feel of the classics, it would most likely come off as a facsimile of them, an imitation without any depth. They'd probably end up being forgotten as inferior versions of what the classics did well. Am I making this clear enough, or should I keep going? However, I think these films do more than just follow the genre. They push it forward. Thank you.